Here's a short recap from the last part. After completing his training under Drake, Ash and the Elder return to the Johto region. Instead of re-challenging the Olivine City Gym right away, they decided to challenge the Cyanwood City Gym first. This pitted Ash against the gym leader Chuck, who was a fighting type expert. It was a closely fought battle, with Ash's Trico evolving into Glowile in the end and securing the victory. Now we continue the story. After finishing up his gym battle and resting for a bit, Ash and the Elder decided to head back to Olivine City to finally get his rematch against Jasmine. But before that, the Elder advised Ash to visit the Whirl Islands, which was an excellent spot for training water type Pokemon. He advised that Feebas and Lapras would definitely benefit from training there. So with that, Ash swapped his Skarmory for Feebas, as he figured that Skarmory won't do much good in the upcoming gym battle. They both arrived at Whirl Islands, and after getting adjusted to the climate, the training began. And truly enough, this training showed great improvements for not only Lapras but also Feebas. Lapras, of course, was doing her mentor role here and training Feebas in durability and speed. On one day of training, they ran into a stranger. The Elder immediately recognized him as the champion of the Hoenn region, Wallace. Ash was excited to see him and remembered reading about him in a magazine. He asked Wallace if he is truly the water type expert of the Hoenn region, and Wallace told him that that's quite a flattering way to be introduced to someone. Ash immediately asked him for a battle, and Wallace told him that although he was here to study on a rare Pokemon, a battle wouldn't be so bad. He told Ash that this will be a 3-on-3 battle, where after every elimination they will have to switch Pokemons. So basically it will be a best of three battle. The first battle pitted Ash's Growlithe against Wallace's Whiscash. Growlithe immediately leapt forward and tried to hit Whiscash with a Leaf Blade attack, which would have been quadruple effective on the water ground type. However, before Growlithe could land the hit, it was hit square with a Blizzard attack, which caused it to be frozen and thus defeated. The next battle saw Ash use his Dragalge and Wallace send out his Ludicolo. Dragalge performed way better than Growlithe did, tanking many of Ludicolo's hit, even hitting it with a Sludge Wave, which did some amount of damage. However, it was soon taken out by an Ice Punch attack. The final battle saw Ash's Pupitar versus Wallace's Milotic. Although Ash hadn't battled alongside Pupitar for a long time, their teamwork did not show any signs of fight rusting. Pupitar was able to hit Milotic with some solid shots, including a powerful Dark Pulse which even caused a flinch. However, the type disadvantage and the level discrepancy proved to be too much, and a Surf attack completely washed Pupitar away, giving Wallace the clean sweep. Ash was not disappointed. He kind of expected this to happen. He then asked Wallace for a favor. He asked him if Milotic is the evolved form of Feebas, and Wallace confirmed it. Ash then showed him his own Feebas and asked Wallace to help him train it, and Wallace gladly accepted. So for the next day, they stayed at the Whirl Island training together, and Feebas saw some definite improvement in its game. One day of training, Ash spotted a strange Pokemon near the beach. He went over to examine it and realized that it's a baby Pokemon. Wallace screamed at Ash to get away from it, as this is a baby Lugia, which means that the parent is not far away at all, and it gets really protective over its offspring. However, Ash brushes it off, saying that he previously owned a baby Latias and he has experience dealing with small Pokemon. But as soon as Ash began to pick it up, it started to scream and cry. This immediately prompted the mother Lugia to dive out of the water and immediately start to attack the group. Wallace tells Ash and the Elder to retreat, and saying that he will hold Lugia off. He sends out his Milotic, and Milotic tries its best to hold off the legendary Pokemon. Although it has some success due to being such well trained, it's clearly evident that Lugia is on another level right now. Phoebus, not thinking, jumps in front of one of Lugia's attack, trying to defend Milotic, as it had developed a bond with it similar to its bond with Lapras. However, before Lugia could hit Milotic, Phoebus, Milotic once again jumped in front of it and fired off an Ice Beam to defend it. The Ice Beam hit Lugia head on, but it just tanked it and kept moving forward. Phoebus also leapt in and tried to help Milotic, and in its drive to protect its trainers, Phoebus finally evolved into Milotic itself. The two fully evolved water type managed to hold Lugia off for long enough that the group was able to escape the World Islands. Upon returning to Cyanwood City, Wallace bid farewell to both Ash and the Elder, saying that now that he has not only spotted but also battled Lugia, his purpose of coming to the Johto region was complete. But he promises Ash that they will meet somewhere down the line, and when they do, they will definitely have a rematch. Ash is excited and motivated after this training, and now decides to head to Olivine City to finally challenge Jasmine once again. Upon arriving at Olivine City, Ash decides to make some changes to his team. Despite the Elder's advice of not doing it, Ash decides to use the same Pokemon that he used last time, as he owed them this victory, as the last time they had basically lost because of his overconfidence and insistence on making wrong decisions throughout the battle. So this time, this was a redemption battle for them. The next day, he arrived at the Olivine City Gym to challenge Jasmine, who told Ash that she did not expect him to arrive again after that one-sided defeat. Ash told her that this time he will not make the same mistakes that he did before, and he is a different trainer than he was that time. So with that, Jasmine declares this will be a 3-on-3 battle, and Ash tells her not to hold anything back and use her strongest Pokemon, and Jasmine obliges to this wish once again. This time she leads off with Aggron, and Ash leads with Nidoking. These two powerful Pokemon stare each other down and with a mighty roar start to battle it out, without even listening to the trainer's instructions. And this battle plays out as you would expect. Both of them, not even using any attacks, just start to brawl it out, trying to gauge each other's strength. They prove even in strength. So the first coordinated attack that both of them threw are Flash Cannon and Thunderbolt, which collide in the middle of the stadium, creating a huge explosion, cancelling each other out. Just then, Nidoking leaps in front of Aggron, trying to hit a double kick. However, Aggron dodges the attack and instead hits Nidoking with a double edge attack, which sends it crashing. Ash, expecting a recoil damage, tells Nidoking to wait. However, the recoil damage never comes. Jasmine tells Ash that this is because Aggron has the ability Rock Head, which negates any recoil damages. So Ash decides in that case he will have to reveal his secret weapon, which he was saving for his Steelix. This is the Earth Power Attack. The quadruple effective move instantly takes Aggron out, proving that Nidoking was holding back this entire time, trying to save this move and keep it up its sleeve. But now that Aggron had shown to be much stronger than Ash had thought, he had no choice but to reveal this move. For the next battle, Jasmine sends out a Steelix, and Ash immediately recognizes that this is not the same Steelix from before, and he asks Jasmine about it, and Jasmine tells him that yes, that it is true, this is not the Steelix from before, and she is saving that for her last Pokemon. Ash notices that this Steelix is much smaller than before, so he sends out his Onix. Onix is determined to win against its evolved stage, no matter if it's a different Steelix. The battle begins as Ash orders Onix to use Curse Attack. This lowers its speed, but also enhances its attack and defense. and this proves vital, as when Jasmine orders Steelix to use an Iron Tail, Ash orders the same. And although Onyx's Iron Tail is not as powerful as its evolved form, it manages to cancel it out nonetheless due to the defense and attack boost it had gotten just a while ago. Onyx follows this up with a Sand Tomb attack, which traps Steelix and does damage in every turn. They both collide once again, and although Steelix seems to have the power advantage, Onyx is proving to be the more durable of the two. Steelix manages to hit Onyx with a powerful Iron Tail, but unlike the last time, Onyx brushes it off and hits Steelix with its own. And although this does not cause Steelix to faint, this manages to get it to back off, and this gives Onyx an opening to go for an Earthquake attack. However, Jasmine orders the same, and the two super effective moves collide and taking both of the Pokemon out. Ash recalls Onyx saying that it is proud of the progress that he has made so far. For the next battle, Jasmine finally sends out her most powerful Steelix, and Ash sends out Nidoking. Steelix immediately goes for an Iron Tail. However, Ash tells Nidoking to counter it with Flamethrower. Flamethrower stops the Steel-type moves in its tracks, and Nidoking follows this up by a powerful double kick. Steelix tries to get the speed advantage, tries to hold Nidoking down, but Nidoking is the much faster Pokemon and manages to hit Steelix with a Flamethrower and double kick combo. It then charges up an Earth Power, but it gets cancelled out by an Earthquake by Steelix, which eventually takes the poison type out. For his last Pokemon, Ash sends out Gible, and Gible tries its best to hold its own against the Steel type. However, this just like the last battle, this is proving to be futile. Whenever Gible tries to go for a Dig attack, Steelix disrupts it using an Earthquake. Its Iron Tail is proving to be much more powerful than Gible's Dragon Claw. However, one more time, as Steelix tries to hit it with an Iron Tail, Ash orders Gible to bite it down. And just like the last battle, Gible, through sheer toughness and stubbornness, holds on to the Iron Tail, not letting go, despite taking massive damage. Jasmine once again tells Ash that this is pointless, as she orders a Dragon Breath. But unlike before, Gible does not faint. It holds on, trying to absorb the Dragon Breath into itself. And this eventually works, as Gible starts to glow and evolves into Gibite, not willing to go down in defeat the same way as before. A blue aura starts to surround Gibite as it charges up its newest move. This is Dragon Rush. As Gible takes the Iron Tail with the Dragon Rush and hits Steelix with not only the Dragon Rush but also its own move. And this combo attack is enough to take Steelix out and give Ash the victory and the mineral badge. Jasmine tells Ash that she is proud of him for making the improvements and winning the rematch. However, there will be a trilogy down the line. Ash tells her that when he becomes the champion, he will make sure to defend his title against Jasmine for the first time. Ash then makes another request to Jasmine, as he asks Jasmine to train his Onyx for him. After seeing her Steelix battle at such a high level, he knows that the best training that Onyx can receive is under her. And after thinking for a minute, she accepts it and tells Ash that she will return his Onyx after he has won his final gym badge. So with that, they both set out of the Ash and the Elder set out of the gym. This is where the Elder parts ways with Ash and tells him that the main reason that he decided to travel with Ash was to introduce him to Drake and help him regain his confidence. And now that his job is done, he will be waiting for Ash in Blackthorn City, where he will challenge his final gym. But before that, he gives Ash some warnings about his next gym challenge, which will be against Pyres, who is an ice type, and thus has a really good track record against the trainers from the Dragon Clan. And he tells Ash not to lose that battle, as the dignity of the Dragon Clan is at stake. Ash promises him that he won't, and he will be seeing him in Blackthorn soon enough. And guys, that's where I will be ending this part. Thank you for watching. If you have any suggestions regarding the story, make sure to join the Discord, the link of which is provided in the description below. Stay safe guys, take it easy and God bless.